Hi, thanks for watching 1minutedigital.com. Today we're going to work in Adobe Illustrator, and it's a 3-for-1 in this tutorial. I'm going to show you how to make typecast a shadow in 3 different ways: as a tabletop reflection, light from behind, and light coming from in front. So the first thing you do in Illustrator, open a new document, OK, and type the word that you want to make cast the shadow. With that word selected, go up to Edit, Copy, Edit, Paste in Place. With that selected, use your arrow key to bump it down a little bit so we can work with it. And then go to Type, Create Outlines. With that still selected, go over to the left-hand side, find these two kissing triangles. That's the Reflect tool. Now holding down the Shift key, click inside the first letter, the letter O here, and drag it slightly to the right until it makes a mirror reflection. With that still selected, on the left-hand side, you'll find this little box, and it's called the Gradient tool. Double-click on that. In the box that opens up, change the type to Linear and the angle to 90 degrees. With that still selected, let's bump it up a little bit till it gets right underneath our letter form, the tops and bottoms matching. Looks good. I like to go over here to the slider on the left here that goes from white to black, and click the white part of that and change the opacity to 0. Go to Window, Transparency, and change the opacity to anywhere from 20 to 60%, something like that, 65%. Makes it a little bit more shadowy. And there you have a tabletop gradient reflection. If you want to make it look like that light is coming from behind the word and casting a shadow at an angle, all you do is, with your shadow selected, go over again to the left and find these two triangles, rectangles. It's called the Shear tool. Double click on that. And in this box, change the shear angle to about 40, 50%. Click Preview, OK. And just use your arrow key to bump that over until it gets to be in the right place. And there you have a reflection, a shadow that looks like light is coming from behind the letter. If you want to make it look like light is coming from in front of the letter, casting a shadow behind it, just keep that shadow layer selected and hover over the little white square until you get the two up and down arrows. Click and drag it behind. Don't go too far. Just make it look like a little bit of shadow at an angle there. Go to Object, Arrange, Send to Back. And now you have light coming from in front of the letter form. Here's a little trick if you want to work with color. On the top layer, the type layer, highlight the word that you want to be in color and go to Window, Swatches. Select the color you would like it to be, and now you have your top part in color. It's a good idea to go ahead and select that again, go up to Object Lock Selection. That will lock this so you don't accidentally select it. Now, using the white arrow, that is the Direct Selection tool, click and drag and select over only the shadow type that you want to be in color. In this case, it's the word Minute. And then go over here to the gradient again, not to the swatches, to the gradient. Double click on the black part of that gradient slider and select the color that you use so it matches. I think it was that one. And now you have your type casting a shadow in color. So that was your 1 minute times three minute digital tutorial of type with 3 different reflections. Hope you enjoyed it. Hope it was helpful. And thanks again for watching. More to come. Until next time. Bye-bye.